we're now starting to think a little bit more about the shape of data that comes back from a query. So let's now take this idea of the shape of data that comes back to us and apply it to the world of subqueries. All right, so as we saw just a moment ago, we can insert different subqueries in different locations in a query. And as I mentioned, each of these different subqueries in these different locations must return different shapes of data. So the first scenario that we're going to consider is putting in a subquery into a select statement. If we want to add a subquery into a select statement, we must add in a subquery that's going to result in a single value. So in this case, if we want to add in a subquery right here, it must be a subquery that's going to give us back just one single value, or just one row with one column. So for example, we might write out a subquery inside of here that looks like this. We are trying to select the max price out of our entire table of products. Only one value is going to come back from this subquery. We're asking for the max price, so we're going to get just the max price out of all the price values. Because this subquery returns a single value, we are allowed to insert it into this select statement as a subquery. Let's go and try to execute just this query by itself. We're going to verify that it does give us just one single value, and then we'll try to integrate that into a larger query. Okay, so I'm going to do a select max price from products. And if I run that, I'll see very easily that we get back one single value. So again, I'm going to repeat it for a third time now. Because we get back one single value from this subquery, we are allowed to insert it into a select statement. Let's now write out this entire outer query, and then we'll move this subquery into the select statement. So I'm going to delete the subquery for right now and replace it with a select name and price. And then right here, I'm going to put in a set of parentheses to indicate that we're going to add in a subquery. So I will say select max price from products. Notice that I'm not putting in any semicolon at the end of this subquery or anything like that. It is just the subquery by itself. So then we can finish off the rest of the query. We can say from products where price is greater than 867. Now we should be able to run this. And yep, we get back a result. Now in this case, having a subquery inside of here is not super meaningful. I'm not too worried about showing you very meaningful queries right now. Instead, I really just want to focus on understanding the rules of subqueries and where we can put different types of data. So showing the max price next to every single product, it's not super useful. Nonetheless, again, I really just want you to get used to the idea of making use of subqueries and where we can insert each kind of them. All right, so let's take a look at one more example of this. So here's another example. We've got another query right here that's hopefully going to give us back one single value. We are asking for a price from products, specifically for the product with an ID of 3. That should give us back just one row and one column. Now we are making a little bit of an assumption here. We are assuming that there is a product with an ID of 3. If we were asking for a product that did not exist, that would give us back a null result. So we're kind of bending the rules here just a little bit, but you and I know very well that this will return one single value for right now. So it's good enough for our purposes. So because this is going to return one single value, again, we are allowed to insert this as a subquery inside of a select statement. So again, let's try to execute this subquery by itself and just verify that it gives us back one value. We'll say select price from products where ID equals 3. I'll run that. Yep, we definitely get back a value. We get one single value, and because of that, we can use this inside of a select statement as a subquery. Then we can, again, write out the large query or the outside one. We'll get name, price, and then insert the subquery right here. So select price from products where ID equals 3. And we'll add in our from products where price is greater than 867. So now we can run this, and yep, it works again. Now, in this case, you'll notice that we get a little bit of an interesting result here. We're seeing that all of our different products have a price of 10 and a price of 10. That's because we've got two values of price coming out, where we have essentially two columns that are named the exact same thing. And so the tool that we are using here is essentially pgsql.com is getting just a little bit confused because we have two identically named columns. So we could fix this up by renaming the result of the subquery. So right after the subquery, I'm going to put in an as about ID3 price. And now if I run that, we see the correct result. We've got the price of each individual product and then the renamed column right here. Okay, so we've learned in this video, and I'm going to repeat it for the fourth time. If we have a subquery that returns a single value, we can make use of that inside of a select statement. So now that we understand this first rule around subqueries, let's pause right here and take a look at the second rule in the next video.